In this video, we will discuss about the metronidazole, widely known as Flagyl, as a pharmacotherapeutic agent for amoebiasis. The outline for today's discussion would be the following. First of all, we will talk about the metronidazole pharmacological class and spectrum of activity against other microorganisms, mechanism of action of metronidazole, chemical structure of metronidazole, pharmacokinetics and adverse effects of metronidazole, dosage and dose adjustment, and at last, we will briefly talk about the tinidazole as well. Metronidazole is the drug of choice for treating amoebic infections. It is a mixed amoebicide, meaning it kills amoebas causing luminal amoebiasis as well as effective and systemic amoebiasis. But generally, it is not considered for patients with luminal amoebiasis who are asymptomatic and releasing cysts, for which luminal amoebicides are used, right? Instead, metronidazole is widely used for invasive and extraintestinal amoebiasis in combination with a luminal amoebicide mostly. We have discussed about these in our previous video, so I would recommend watching it first for a better understanding of the use of metronidazole in amoebiasis. So for now, metronidazole is also used in the treatment of other infections caused by other protozoans like Giardia lamblia and Trichomonas vaginalis, and anaerobic bacteria like gram-negative bacilli such as bacteroid species, and it is the drug of choice for the treatment of pseudomembranous colitis caused by the anaerobic gram-positive bacillus Clostridium difficile, C. diff for short. But for this, vancomycin is mostly considered now, but still in some cases metronidazole is combined with vancomycin for severe infection. So, what is the mechanism of action of metronidazole? But before discussing the mechanism of action of metronidazole, let's see the chemical structure of metronidazole first. This is the chemical structure of metronidazole. This ring is called the imidazole ring. And that's why this medicine is named as metronidazole, nidazole, right? While me indicate this methyl group, while etro is for this nitro group, okay? After taking the metronidazole orally or parenterally, the drug gets absorbed by diffusion into the amoebic cell and other sensitive microorganisms. Amoebas and other susceptible microorganisms possess transport proteins such as pyridoxin, which transfer electron to the nitro group of metronidazole, forming a nitroso free radical. And that is why only anaerobes are sensitive to metronidazole. This free radical then interacts with the DNA, resulting in inhibition of DNA synthesis, in degradation, and ultimately cell death. The pharmacokinetic studies of metronidazole show that metronidazole is completely and rapidly absorbed after oral administration. Metronidazole distributes well throughout the body tissues and fluids. Metabolism of the drug depends on hepatic oxidation by mixed function oxidase followed by glucuronidation. The parent drug and its metabolites are excreted in the urine. The most common adverse effects associated with metronidazole treatment are nausea and vomiting, epigastric distress, and abdominal cramps. Additionally, patients commonly feel an unpleasant metallic taste as well. Infrequent adverse effects include hypersensitivity reactions, dark urine, paresthesia, and yeast infection of the oral cavity. If taken with alcohol, a disulfiram-like reaction may occur. So, it should be also avoided with medications like cough syrups containing some kind of alcohol as excipients. As for dosage and dose adjustment, in adults, for amoebiasis, the dose is generally 500 to 750 mg by mouth every 8 hours for 5 to 10 days. while in children, a dose of 35 to 50 mg per kg per day divided into 3 doses. Maximum dose of metronidazole is 750 mg per dose. Metronidazole also may be used intravenously in case of severe infection. In case of dose adjustment, so there is no need for dose adjustment in the case of renal failure. However, the dose must be modified in case of hepatic failure according to the child FUX score. And lastly, let's briefly discuss about the tinidazole. Tinidazole is a second generation nitroimidazole with activity, absorption, side effects, and medication interactions similar to metronidazole. Tinidazole is equally effective as metronidazole but requires a shorter duration of treatment. Throughout therapy, alcohol use should be avoided. And with this, thanks for watching. Do like this video and subscribe.